Good morning, students. So in the last class, we ended up with solving linear programming problems, and today we are going to start with transportation problems. So a transportation problem basically is again an application of linear programming, which basically is applied in the area of physical distribution of goods and services from certain supply points to certain demand points. So while looking after the solutions of transportation problem, it is divided into two phases. So the two phases are, the very first is we are going to identify the basic feasible solutions, and then we are going to find the optimal solutions. So the very first thing is identify basic feasible solution, and the second is to find out the optimal solutions. So these two phases have different methods for identifying the basic feasible solution and the optimal solution. And to identify the basic feasible solution, we have three different ways we are going to look into the problem. The very first is your northwest corner rule. The second one is your minimum cost method, and the third one is your penalty cost method, which is also known as VAM, that is Vogel approximation method. So these are the three methods via which we are going to find out the basic feasible solution. So, and then we move to the second phase, that is to identify the or to get the optimal solution. So we are going to have two methods here. The very first is your stepping stone method, and the second one is your MODI method, that is modified distribution method, which is also known as UV method. So we are going to look after all these methods via some numerical problems. So we'll start with a numerical problem. A transportation problem is going to have a more convenient matrix. So we have this three row and four column problem, which is going to represent a transportation problem having three supply points and four demand points. So the supply points are 40, 60 and 50. Similarly, the demand points are 20, 30, 50 and 50. And the total of all these, like 40 plus 60 plus 50, is equal to 150. And if you total it like this way, 20 plus 30 plus 50 plus 50 again is 150. So that shows this transportation problem is a balanced problem. And the cost per unit for supplying the supplies from I to J for the very first cell, that is Cij, is given by 4, 6, 8, 8. Then it is 6, 8, 7, sorry, 6, 8, 6, 7, and then it is 5, 7, 6, and 8. So these are the cost per cell for transporting one unit of supply to the destination point. So we are going to look this problem via all the three methods, that is the very first is your northwest corner rule, then we are going to solve it via minimum cost method, and then via penalty cost method. So taking the very first, that is northwest corner rule, when we are going to solve the problem via northwest corner rule, what we are going to do is, in this matrix we are going to identify the northwest corner. So in this matrix, the northwest corner is this cell, and otherwise you can just say that you are going to look at the top corner of your left hand. So this is the this cell. That means the very first allocation will be done in this particular cell. Now we look the corresponding values of these are the supplies and these are your demand points. Okay, so we are just going to look up the corresponding values. So against this we have a supply of 40 and we have a requirement of 20. So what we are going to do is we will try to put as much as possible as we can do here. Now in that case we are going to look for the minimum out of 40 and 20, and the minimum is 20. So we are going to allocate 20 to this particular cell. Now what will happen further? As we have allocated 20 out of this 40, so 20 has gone, we are left with 20 more. And talking about the demand side, we have given allocated the full complete 20. That means this all has been exhausted. So we are going to put a dash against this, that this demand has been met. Now further moving, what we are going to do, we again are going to look after the northwest corner of this matrix. So this cell is the now the northwest corner of this matrix, and again you can say it is the topmost corner of your left hand. So again we are going to see the corresponding values of demand and supplies. So here we have a supply of 20 and a demand of 30. So we are going to allocate the minimum one. So the minimum is 20. So again we are going to allocate 20 to this particular cell. So that says that this 20 has been fully utilized. That means this all is exhausted. Then looking to the demand point, we have allocated 20, and here the demand was 30. So we are left with 10 more. So we are 10 is left and 20 is being allocated. Now again moving to the remaining matrix, we are going to look after the again the north corner of this cell, northwest corner. So that is this cell. So we have a supply of 60. 60 can come in, and we have a requirement of 10 only. So we are going to allocate the minimum, that is 10. That means this gets exhausted, so put a dash again, and here we are left with 50. So again this is your northwest corner of this particular matrix. So 50, the supply is 50. 50 can come in, and the demand is also 50. So we can allocate 50 here. So that says this also gets exhausted and this also gets exhausted, and then we are just left with last cell. 50 is the supply and 50 is the demand, and we are going to allocate the 50 here. So this is how we are going to allocate the demand and supplies in this particular matrix. So now you can see everything is balanced. Jitni, as much as there was requirement and as much as there was supply, all are being matched. So this is the solution for basic feasible solution via your northwest corner rule. Now what we need to find out next is we need to find out the cost associated specific to this method. So how we are going to find out the cost? These were the per unit cost. So these are the units which are allocated in these particular cells. So we are going to multiply these two values. That means 4 into 20 plus 6 into 20 plus 8 into 10, 5 into 6 into 50, 8 into 50. So, and we are going to add them. So, we are going to calculate the cost associated which is 14 into 20 plus 16 into again 20 plus 10 into 8 plus 6 into 50 plus 8 into 50, and this will approximately give you a value of 960. So that means this will be the cost if we are going to allocate the units as per. Okay, now we are going to represent the problem again, and this time we are going to represent the problem with the help of a minimum cost method. So I have drawn again the same transportation problem, which have supply points 40, 60 and 50, and then we have supply points, demand points 20, 30, 50 and 50. So now what we are going to do here is we are going to identify the very first step in this minimum cost method. I will just write down the name. Okay, so what we are going to do here is we are going to identify the minimum cost cell. We are going to look after this whole matrix and we are going to identify the cell which have the minimum cost value. So we can see this cell is having the minimum cost, that is 4. That means we are going to start taking our decisions through this cell. So the first allocation will be done in this particular cell. Again, the supply is 40. 40 can come in, but the requirement is only 20. So we are going to allocate the minimum, that is 20. So that says that as 20 is allocated, we are left only with this 20 here. And then as 20 is required here, this all has been allocated. So this gets exhausted. Then we again are going to see for the minimum cost cell. So now see, the minimum cost is 6. And now we have a tie between 3, 6. One is this, second one is this, and third one is this. Now which one to choose and which one to drop? So you can choose it on your choice based system. Any value or any minimum cell cost cell can be selected. So I have taken this cell. So that means we are going to take a decision for this cell. We are going to allocate the units for this cell first. So see, 60 can come in and 50 can go. 50 is the demand. So 60 and 50, the minimum is 50. So that says that we are going to allocate 50 to this particular cell, which says that we are left with only 10 supply is available here, and this 50 is purely exhausted. Now again look for the minimum cost cell. So again we have 6 here. This 6 has been exhausted. We are left with only this 6. So we are going to allocate the values here. So now you see here 20 can come in and 30 is required. So the minimum is 20. So we are going to allocate 20 here. Now what we are going to do is, again, as full 20 has been given, so this gets exhausted. And here 20 has been allocated, but the demand was 30. So we are left with 10. Okay. So now again we are going to look after the minimum cost cell, that is your 7. So again we have 2 7s and we have a tie. So I have taken this 7. So here the demand is 10 and the supply is 50. 50 can come in, but only 10 is required. So we are going to allocate 10 here. That says this has been exhausted and here we are just left with 40. Done. Again look for minimum cost cell, that is this 7. So here 10 can come in and 50 is required. So allocate the minimum value. So this 10 gets exhausted. Then and here the requirement remains just for 40. So now the minimum cost cell is only 8. We are only left with 8. In last two cells we don't have any choices. So 40 is the requirement and 40 is the supply. So we are going to allocate 40 here. So this is how it goes on. Now we are going to again calculate the cost associated with this particular method. So now you see, in whatever cell we have allocated the units, we are going to calculate the cost. So the cost associated will be 4 into 20 plus 6 into 20 plus 6 into 50 plus 7 into 10 plus 7 into 10 plus 8 into 40. And the cost associated here would be somewhere equal to 960. Again, so 80 plus 120 plus 300 plus 70 plus 70 plus 320, that gives you 960. So this is how you're going to calculate the cost associated. So in the previous method also the cost associated was sorry, in previous method it was 980. That was your northwest corner. Minimum cost 960, and now we are left with one more method, that is your penalty method, which is also known as Vogel approximation method, and we are going to calculate the cost associated, that is the objective function. So now we are going to look after this similar problem via penalty cost method. So penalty cost method is basically going to look after the penalties which are going to incur if we are not going to allocate the units in the minimum cost cell. So talking about this method, the very first step that we need to perform here is we are going to compute the penalties. Now how the penalties are to be computed, we are going to look for the first row, then for the second row, then for the third row. Similarly, we are going to look for the first column, then the second column, third column and fourth column. So talking about the very first row, the minimum value cell is 4. So that means if we are not going to allocate the units to this particular cell, then the penalty that will incur will be the difference between the minimum value and the next minimum value in this particular row. So in this row, the minimum value is 4 and the next minimum value is 6, and the difference between these two is 2. So that means the penalty associated with this particular row is 2, or this particular cell is 2. Then talking about this row 2, the minimum value is 6 and the next minimum is 8. Again, sorry, the next minimum is 7, but the penalty is 7, 6 minus 7, 7 minus 6, that is 1. And in the last row, you can see 5 is the minimum value and the next minimum value is 6. Again, the difference is 1. So these are the penalties associated with these particular rows. So as we want to minimize the objective function is the cost associated with transportation. So we would like to put as much as possible in a particular cell so that we can minimize the objective function. And if we are not in a capacity to do so, then there will be a penalty. That means the extra cost per unit per cell that we will increase in the objective function. So that is your penalties for the rows. Talking about the columns, the minimum value is 4, the next minimum is 5, so the penalty is 1. Then 6 is the minimum value, 7 is the next minimum, again the penalty is 1. 6, next minimum is also 6, the penalty is 0. Then 7 and 8, and the penalty is 1. So this is the very first step, that we are going to compute the penalties. Now what we are going to do next is, the very first step was to compute the penalties. Next we are going to look after these penalties of all the rows and the columns, and we are going to identify the maximum penalty. So that is this 2. That is of most importance to us. That means we are going to take decisions to this particular row on the very prior basis. So we are going to allocate the values to this row and to the minimum cell. So 20 can come in, and sorry, it is not 20, it is 40. The supplier was 40. Okay, 40 can come in, 20 is only required. So what happens here, we are going to allocate 20. That means this hole gets exhausted and we are left with 20. Now what next? Again we are going to compute the penalties. So looking for the very first row, that is 6 is the minimum value and the next minimum is 8, so the penalty remains 2. Then coming to this next 6 and 7, the penalty is 1. Then coming to the third row, the minimum value is 6 now and the next minimum is 7, the penalty is 1. Then coming to the columns, the values will not change, the penalties will remain same. Then again allocating the values, so the maximum penalty again falls in the row 1. So we are going to allocate the values again for row 1 and for the minimum cell. So 20 can come in and 30 is required. So we are going to allocate the minimum, that is 20. So put 20 here. That means 20 has been used, only 10 is left, and this all gets exhausted. Then again we are going to compute the penalties. Now see, 6 is the minimum value. Now this row is exhausted, we are not going to compute the penalty. 6 is the minimum value, next minimum is 7, then we have a 1. Again 6 is the minimum, next minimum is 7, 6 minus 7 is again 1, here 7 minus 6 is 1. Then for the columns, here the minimum is 7 and next minimum is 8, the penalty is 1. 6 and 6, penalty is 0, 7 and 8, penalty is 1. Now we are going to look after the maximum penalty. Now you can see we are having these 4, there is a tie between these 4s. We have 1 at 4 places as penalty, so again we are going to randomly choose 1. So I have taken this one. So we are going to take a decision against this. So the minimum cell against this is 7. So the value or the units required are 10, and the units which can come in are 60. So we are going to put the minimum, that is 10. That means, sorry, this gets exhausted. Now as you can see that we have calculated the penalties, again there is a tie between these 4. So randomly I am going to choose this one. That means in this particular row 7 is the minimum value. That is, I am going to, 7 is the minimum value, and we are going to allocate the value to this cell. So 10 is the requirement and 50 can come in. So the 10 is the minimum value, so we are going to allocate the minimum. So we have allocated 10, and here we are left with 40, and this gets exhausted and this also gets exhausted. Now again we are going to calculate the penalties of these cells. So looking for this row, the minimum is 6 and the next minimum is 7, so the penalty is 1. Now looking for this row, the minimum is 6 and the next minimum is 8, and the penalty will be here 2. Looking for the columns, 6 and 6, the penalty is 0, and 7 and 8, the penalty is 1. Now we are going to look for the maximum penalty, and the maximum penalty is 2. That means we are going to take the decisions for this row first. So this is the minimum cell value, that is 6, so we are going to allocate the units here first. So 50 is required and 40 can come in. So that means we are going to allocate the minimum, that is 40. That is, we are left with 10 here, and this basically gets exhausted. Now we are only left with a single row, that is second row, and here the minimum value is 6 and 7, so that we have two values, 6 and 7, and the minimum value is 6. That means firstly we are going to allocate the values to this particular cell, as this cell have the minimum cost. So 60 is which can come in, and 10 is required, so we can only allocate 10, and here we are left with 50. So we are left with a 50 here, and again a demand of 50 is here, and we are only left with one single cell, that is this. So 50 can come in and 50 is required, so we are going to put a 50 here. So we are going to allocate a 50 here also. Now what next we are going to calculate? The cost associated with this particular method, that is the objective function. So we are trying to find out basic feasible solution which is going to have a minimum objective function. So here 20 into 4, 6 into 20, plus 6 into 10, plus 7 into 50, plus 7 into 10, plus 6 into 40. So here the approximate cost which will come is 920. So we calculated the objective function for three methods. The very first method we got it 980, then it was 960, and via this method the objective function or the cost associated is 920. So you can see the basic difference between these three methods. If you go back to the very first method, that is your northwest corner rule, there were only 5 allocations. Like here we have 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We had 5 allocations and the cost was 980. And talking about minimum cost method, again there we were having 6 allocations, as we have 6 allocations here, and the cost was 960. And talking about this penalty cost method or Vogel approximation method, we again have 6 allocations and the cost is 920. So the minimum cost is 920. Now this was the first phase of finding a solution to the transportation problem, where we tried 3 methods via which we tried to solve and identify the basic feasible solution. Now we can take any one of the method or any one of the basic or feasible solution for finding out the optimal solution, which will be calculated or solved via 2 methods. The very first is stepping stone method and your UV method. So they will be taken care of in the next lecture.